Eldridge, who's heading up the makeup here at Osman. So Lisa, can you tell me a little bit about the inspiration for the look today?
Well, it's got a little bit of a 20s vibe to it, but not sort of, I mean, Osman stuff's very, very minimal and very modern, so it's a very modern take on the 20s. So I'm doing a sort of metallic eye, which is quite sort of soft and cloud-like, and then at the last minute, I'm going to be adding sort of liquid gloss all over the lid, so we're going to get that really sort of lived-in, very, very, almost like a mirror-like shine on the metallic eyes, and then very, very dark and intense liner, so quite close to the lashes. Skin just beautifully polished, pretty dewy on the skin, so lots of sort of highlight around the edges, a little bit more matte down the center, and then a stain, a sort of almost like a bruised lip, so this sort of reddy, plummy bruised lip, which is gonna, I'm gonna put some mixing medium over the top, so it's gonna be very, very matte.
So James, I can already see it's pretty crazy hair.
Whoa, there's a lot of wigs today. All the wigs for the models are very individual and they're all different. We're setting it with their hairspray and then we're painting them.
Okay, so here we are, last day of London Fashion Week. You've done some serious shows this week, haven't you?
Yes, I have been very grateful for blessings I have come across in London.
And who has been your favorite so far?
My favorite so far is Toddler. Toddler was an amazing show. Toddlin, Ashley, I'm sorry.
Oh, my shoes are slipping off.
Toddlin.
Last day of Fashion Week, how has it been for you?
It's been awesome, I'm loving it. I'm loving all the clothes, the backstage, the excitement. It's great.
Amazing. Any dramas at all?
Just rushing in between, had to rush to this show from another, so just lots of rushing and jumping in taxis. Yeah.
So you haven't quite fallen off your high heels yet?
No, that hasn't happened, thank God, but yeah.
Of London Fashion Week. What's London Fashion Week like for a model's perspective?
Well, obviously it's kind of behind the scenes a lot busier than what you imagine. When you see everything on the catwalk, everyone's really looks like they're toed together and like it just sort of happens like that. But you know, it's like manic beforehand. So yeah, they're kind of panicking a lot before, you're like running around castings, like sweating and like looking really bad, and then you have to just get it together really quickly. So
And what have you been surviving on?
Normal stuff. I mean, like, you have to kind of eat snacky food, just like eat something as you're going, like walking around and stuff. So, like, pop into the model sanctuary, they like do really nice food there. Like, they've been giving away like stuff from Marks and Spencer's and things, which is really good.
So the model sanctuary, that sounds wonderful. What happens there?
Well, Erin O'Connor started it. She found it, and it basically is really good. If you're a model, you get to go there and just like get free food and like get to relax there if you have any spare time and stuff. But they're really nice there. Everyone's so friendly, so you just feel like you can walk in and they'll just sort of let you sit down and have a break for a little bit.
Season in Forest, haven't you? Supporting their London designers. What has stood out for you this week?
I think the sheer talent, the level of talent. You know, we all know and we're aware of how creative London is, but there's a real transformation, I think, between what's creative and what's commercially viable. So we're seeing that design talent, but in a far more slick, sophisticated, grown-up way. And you can see that they're really treating themselves like brands, evolving brands with a view to longevity and to showcasing their work internationally, you know, throughout the fashion capitals. And I think Marielle Schwab pulled it out of the bag the other night, Jonathan Saunders, Giles last night. Thank you, Giles, for bringing theatre back to London. It was so exciting.
And we've been talking to models today and they've been praising your model sanctuary.
So nice, that's good. We had about 300 models in today, so we've had a steady increase throughout the week. 250 yesterday, 100 at the beginning of the week. It's so important that they have a place to be, and outside of, you know, showing and using their bodies.
Now, the last day of Fashion Week, tell me, what has been your highlight so far?
God, so many. I have to say, I've been loving all the prints. I mean, Mary was absolutely breathtakingly beautiful, as was Peter Pilotto yesterday. Nicholas Kirkwood has just been killing it with the shoes at Roxanza and at Peter Pilotto, just amazing. So yeah, really excited to see what he's got left for us. And of course, Christopher Kane to die for. So yeah, it's been really, really, really fun Fashion Week.
What do you think will be the essential item to purchase next season?
I think there's lots of kind of short fronts, long back. So whether it's been in tops that have got long trains or short skirts with really, really long backs, lots of kind of flowy, beautiful fabrics, yellow. There's definitely been kind of like a holiday vibe with a lot of the collections, whether it's been in the music, it's been kind of seasidey. It's just been, you know, kind of a really, really positive energy going throughout. So yeah, it's been fun.
And any dramas this week? Because fashion is supposed to be dramatic after all.
I know. What has been drama? We've had amazing weather. It was meant to be hideous and it's actually been actually really, really nice. So that's been fun. There was a model that went on Mary Katranzou the wrong way, which was quite funny. It kind of shook us all up. And the Meadham show, my God, that was amazing. It was like a theatrical performance. Honestly, it wasn't even a fashion show. It was a theatre.
What can you do with curly, frizzy hair? Make it go away. New Frizzies 3-Day Straight, our first styling spray made with keratin. It works with your hair straighteners to help create a straight style that can last not one, not two, but 3 days. 3-Day Straight, only from John Frieda.